Okay, guys, Detective Worcestershire, and today, guys, I have a rather large announcement to make, actually. I'm actually reviewing, and, well, obviously not unboxing, because I've already unboxed it, because I was too excited, obviously, to record before doing so. Well, actually, in the truth of that, I unboxed it after I failed the video, so I'm going to have to do this video again, because I'm not always satisfied with my video quality. And that's something that's pretty good, actually, because if I'm not satisfied, I'll do it again and do it over and over again, which is quite repetitive, actually, and inadequate in that way. But it's particularly good when you think about it, because I'll get the best quality footage and review, really. I'm actually reviewing the Roughneck metal detecting spade, obviously being for a purpose. It's pretty much an all-rounder in anything from, say, industrial activity to archaeological digs, really, I have to say, and metal detecting in between that. But guys, it's a micro shovel. It's rather small, but it's extremely easy to use and a lot lighter than my Joseph Benton graduate spade, which is fairly light anyway, and so this is unrealistically extremely light, to be perfectly honest. I can't necessarily speak because my mouth is particularly dry, but no worries about that. I'll just go over to the item itself. Okay, guys, that is it. Now, I purchased this, I believe, from eBay, obviously, or my dad purchased it. It was originally for my dad, because obviously he's started metal detecting, because obviously I've got my XP Comics powder. There's the box that it came in, and the obviously instruction manual. I'm making videos those in the not too near future, possibly even far future, because I don't make videos that commonly, but you know, it doesn't really matter. But yep, came with a brilliant guarantee saying it'll last you a lifetime, depending on how long you do live, which may be 90 years, range from, say, I don't know, non-offensively 10 years to these days. If you're my age, then you probably live to 120, the way technology and drugs are increasing, and whatever, scientifically, of course, but yeah. I came, well, that's obviously the packaging it came in, as you can see there, and brilliant. I'm not too particularly sure the weight of it, but I'm sure it's a good 500 grams of an estimate. I'm not that good at estimating, obviously, but still, it's adequate. You can see there, it's obviously tendered, as it says just across there. Roughneck, tough tools for a tough world, obviously, because it is a tough world industrially, and both metal detecting. Because it did actually say metal detecting spade rather than industrial working spade, or just spade if you like sometimes. And these were mass sold, so, and 440 I believe at the time, a week ago when I first bought it, obviously shipped, rather than going all the way to Swindon to get that brilliant, unrealistic machine. That's an hour and 35 minutes away from my own. Myself, so yeah, and the NEL straps around there, just to be pleased about what I bought, and control box over there. But guys, if you want to read more about the Goldmax Power, it's in the description of my Goldmax Power review, depth test related review, obviously, and on part one, obviously, not part two, because it was a very small description. Part one, the original part, has a large description about every specification, how I bought it, and whatever. It's a bit personal, I don't think you really want to read that, but some people are interested, so yeah. As you can see there, it has a barcode, because I have to scan it before going into production, obviously. Well, not in production, but before it's sold, reasonably. Oh no, unless you're buying in the shop, obviously. But not if it's being shipped to you, I don't think. I'm not too experienced in that way, but yeah. Be aware of and avoid both electrical power lines. A severed power line could cause serious injury by electrocution. This tool is not designed or intended for buying. Always wear eye protection when using this tool, except when you're multi-detecting. I don't really think you need to wear eye protection for that. Only gloves, maybe. That's pretty much it. Guarantee. Roughneck guarantees this tool for life against any defect in material or workmanship. So, in material, I mean, you could easily chip a small bronze penny or something, well, not small, rather large bronze penny, or say a little farthing, or just maybe even a buckle might snap it off in the use of this, you know, brilliant well manufactured spade. As you can see, it's tempered. Very nice glossy finish there. Round point micro shovel, and then it has the serial number there. Ergonomic nylon, sorry, D grip handle. When you see there, it says D grip, D handle. That's what it means. Nice rubber coating there. Tough torso to fold. That's their logo, or their whatever it's called. But yeah, contractor grade. It means it's rather good, really. By Olympia Tools United Kingdom Limited, www.olympiatools.co.uk if you want to visit that, to buy one for your own, or just put the eBay sellers page on the in the link in the description if you like. Powering TM handle connection, industrial strength steel blade, lifetime guarantee, as you can see in red there. And it's absolutely brilliant, I have to say. Has this angleization to it, as you can see there. Goes from approximately, say, 10 degrees down to, in great similarity, 15 degrees possibly. But, so when you're getting into the soil, you just put it in there, and you can just easily, like, manoeuvre it in the hole that you've dug. And it's a fairly lengthy head there, so you shouldn't be causing yourself any harm, really. I mean, except for the sharp point on the end. And it penetrates rather deeply into the ground with these hooks on there. But yeah, and then it comes with thank you, purchase, scheduled purchase, whatever, satisfaction or whatever. When leaving feedback, please leave a positive 5-star rating, which is obviously encouraging you to make the seller more positive and absolutely brilliant on eBay. So you might not always be positive, obviously. There's just an advertising company or whatever, maybe Roughneck. I haven't read that yet because I only just unboxed it really. But also, I just recently went to the fishing tackle shop, well, rather locally, if like, approximately 20 minutes away from where I live, and bought this. It's a $4.99, which is a fair price, although you can actually get it from Redstone for about $3.50. I don't particularly mind. It's called a Daiwa Specialist Box Mini. See the number again, as you can see there, and then barcode, don't you? But, this itself, I mean, I can do this additional review to the Roughneck. It's fairly nice. I mean, just latch it open like that. And guys, I'm still actually particularly pleased with the hammered coin that I found. Actually, I might start doing vlogs and vlogging about detecting, obviously. See, like, the news that's going on about it, what I've found, what you found. I mean, well, I can start my own website, which it's in development, but I haven't even started it yet. It means it's not even in development yet, so quite a lie there. I'm not too particularly sure, but yeah. I will eventually make a website, but I don't know when, because it's going to be particularly hard to do, or possibly even a forum on my website. So like Club Up's Metal Detecting Club, obviously. You can visit them in the link in the description if it's there. So I might forget to put it in after watching this video. You can see that. Actually, just you can actually take these out by just pulling them out, and the hook on there, I actually took the string off, but it originally has string. I'll just get an example of my dad's here, so you can see it. If it's still here, that is, which I don't believe it is, but I'll have a look anyway. Yeah, this is 8 minutes 50s. Yep, got it! Boom, okay. You can see that it's got the string on, wrapping from the additional part there, which I haven't exactly done, but yeah, I just took all of the chips out and all the string and put it in this compartment here. Now, this is large enough for flooring, believe it or not. I know it doesn't seem it, but it honestly is. Well, I think that part, actually, not that bit, that's probably large enough for half penny, something like that. Possibly even a penny, not too particularly sure, you should try. But I just lift it up, and yeah, you put your finds in. Keeps them nice and safe, even though a bit of foam in there would make them safe. And that, really, this is the bit that I'm going to put my hammers in, rather than that. That's just a general find and that. Anything larger than flying, say for example a half crown, or possibly even a crown if you're lucky enough, then just put it in your genuine finds pouch, gallet bag, whatever. And those are for the larger finds, something like a buckle. But yeah, that's that. I mean, okay. This is the Roughneck metal detecting spade. I'll make some vlogs and futuristical videos on reviews of the Godmax Power. Speed Godmax Power. Xperia, I believe they're called. Fully, but fully known as, yep. But this, guys, is pretty unreal. And, guys, I'm going to clodhopper dig, I believe, on the, 16th, so it's approximately a week now, 6 days, if well to say, because it's obviously Monday night now, so it's more Tuesday, I'll have scouts, and then so on and so forth, so on and so back, if you like. Yeah, rather pleased with this, although originally my dad was going to have it because he started off the tech, as I said, my Gavitase 250 with the annual tornado 12x13-inch coil, which I'm heavily going to miss because it found me a few with silvers and that. But it doesn't, I mean, for £100, I wouldn't exactly recommend you to buy it because an additional £110 plus postage and packaging, whatever, £120 comes to after postage and packaging, it's not really worth it because it only adds about 8 inches depth, which I would obviously not recommend because depth isn't everything really. So £100 for that, you could buy a new detector rather than doing that. Almost a Gavitase 150, which is in great similarity, actually possibly even the same as the Gavitase 250, except it lacks a few features like the pinpoint function and the notch discriminate, which actually has that. And identification segments and depth segments. See, the Gavitase 150 only has 3, and the Ace 250 only, well, has 4, obviously, which is one more. And, yep, the Ace 150 has 4 identification segments, whereas the 250 has 12 identification segments, I believe. But, yeah, guys, and now, also my recommendation, just seriously my advisement not to do, don't buy the Garrett Euro Ace, because, honestly, it's not worth it. It's exactly the same as the Ace 250, exactly the same, except it has a different, slight different different controls, but just in similarity for European detectorists, it's no different, honestly, it's honestly no different, and I'm afraid that, the difference is the coil, which is approximately, say, £10 more than the actual elliptical one, or 20 or 30, I'm not too particularly sure, because I haven't gone deeply into that. But, it's just a double D coil, whereas the standard Ace 251 is an elliptical one. Which I can't really go into detail because I need to end this video in a minute. But it's honestly fairly good. Trust me, that Spade. I'll be showing you on the field on the clodhopper dig on the 16th of November at Chaddesley Corbett, undetected land. Possibly a few hammers going to come from it, obviously. Hope for a few Victorian silvers, possibly even a, I don't know, Georgian silver, something like that. Hopefully hammered though, and probably a modern penny, knowing my luck. I've found 1,000 of those before. But I have to say, don't buy the Euro Ace. I would not recommend it. I'd honestly, personally, I'd buy the Ace 250, take the elliptical coil off, sell it on eBay brand new, and just go straight for the Double D Gavit elliptical coil, specifically designed and tested for the Ace 250. I'd recommend that, it's exactly the same as the Euro Ace. So guys, I have to say, I'll be using that on the field, on new field, mostly on digs and that, and my new permissions, which hopefully I'll be getting. Hopefully I'll actually be getting permissions galore, because my dad knows this person is a blacksmith who goes around in horseshoes, and he's going to ask pretty much everyone he knows, which is about 50 odd people. Maybe a bit of exaggeration there, but as you can see, it's brilliant. So the Roughneck Spade. Fairly adequate, really, I have to say. It's ingredients, really, have to say. Yeah, guys, as I said, I'll be doing a lot of digs, but I have to do that with my iPhone, obviously, because, I'll have to compile the videos in a compilation because it'll be different digs and everything. I can't just do it for one and that'll take like an hour or so. So, because I have a video editor which is iMovie on my iPhone, and I can't exactly because they don't have a video editor and they cost approximately, say, £90 above one on my computer, my laptop, as you can see there. It lags a bit, but hey ho. technological levels. But yeah, guys, that is pretty much it. Ending at approximately 15 minutes and 10 seconds. I'll have to go see ya. Detective Worcestershire in a bit.